one of the greatest problems with pain is observation. Observation can be as simple as somebody looking over your shoulder, or can be a more complex attack based on hidden cameras and skimming devices. With such devices, an attacker can easily capture your pin as well as your card information. In many common situations, audio and haptic interfaces provide a good example of how it's possible to display information privately. We can then build new pin entry systems based on audio and haptics, where PIN can be represented as a simple sequence of cues. There are basically two interaction techniques. In recognition-based systems, we can encode information in patterns that the user can recognize. So we can build an alphabet of cues and using it for making PINs. In counting-based systems, there is no need to recognize any cue, as there is only one cue. Users simply count that cue and associate it with an action. The haptic keypad is in some way similar to a regular keypad. It's based on a row of three hardware keys, each one featuring a pressure sensor to detect finger presence, a push button to detect item selection, and a vibration motor to render haptic cues. Given a pin as a sequence of haptic cues, the pin entry process is as follows. Three cues are assigned randomly to the three keys. The user searches for the cue in his pin, and when he finds it, he clicks the button on the key. Then all cues are randomly remapped to the keys, and the process continues until the pin is complete. The haptic wheel extends the recognition-based paradigm introduced with the haptic keypad, trying to solve the problem of scalability by changing the way users interact with the interface. The haptic wheel is an electromechanical dial that can spin both left and right. Inside it contains a motor for producing the haptic cues. We designed several versions with different types of actuators. The idea behind the haptic wheel is that cues can be arranged in a specific sequence that can be easily recognized, such as from slow to fast beating pulses. By preserving such order, user can sense just one item from the set of cues and infer the relative location of any other cue. The phone lock system is substantially identical to the haptic wheel. The difference is that it is now based on a mobile device and input happens with a touchscreen. Moreover, the phone lock works with both haptic and audio cues. However, to make the audio cue private, you need headphones. SpinLock is designed for touchscreen smartphones and is inspired by the interface of a dial lock safe. Simple, identical, haptic and audio cues are delivered to the users in response to spinning to the left or to the right. Users need to count how many times a cue is presented. So at the end, the pin is composed by a sequence of directions and numbers. Like for example, two cues on the left, four on the right, three on the left, and so on. Color lock extends the counting interaction model. The interface is composed by the pin slots on the top and four colored buttons below. The pin is a sequence of numbers associated to colors. Cues are now delivered not according to the left or right spinning, but depending on how long you keep a button pressed. The interaction is very simple. Press the button with the color corresponding to your next pin item, then wait until the number of cues that you want is generated. Such time is always randomly computed. time lock is conceptually identical to the color lock prototype. The interaction is almost the same. Cues are selected by dwelling over a button. This time though, cues are not associated with colors, but with a specific input order. In this video, we have briefly presented the idea of concealing private information, such as a PIN or a password, using hidden modalities like haptic and audio, and simple interaction techniques like counting and recognizing cues. In a recent paper, we also have tried to define some design guidelines for invisible passwords, basing our analysis on different trade-offs. Please refer to the paper for details, where you can also find an evaluation of our prototypes and the results of several user studies we conducted. Of course, still a lot of work is needed, and we are planning new prototypes and interaction techniques to make PIN entries safer and more usable than traditional keypads. However, with this video, we hope we gave you a good insight of what is the current research progress, and we also hope that in some way we inspire you in thinking differently about PIN entry in public spaces.